Weeds differ in their growth habits. Broad-leaf dicotyledonous plants have two seed leaves, cotyledons, in each seed. Dicots have broad leaves and may have woody stems. Some species, for example sunflower, only become woody in old parts of stems and roots. These are referred to as semi-herbaceous dicots. Most dicot weeds are herbaceous, having little or no woody tissue, for example, dandelion. Plants that have a single seed leaf are monocotyledons. Monocots have long, narrow leaves with parallel veins and fibrous root systems. Grasses are members of the plant family Gramineae. Some grasses and other woody monocots produce underground stems called rhizomes, such as Kentucky bluegrass, quakegrass, or above-ground runners called stolons, such as creeping bentgrass, while others produce both, such as Bermuda grass. It is important to understand the distinction between monocots and dicots. The selectivity of many herbicides is based on which type of plant they kill. Many herbicides kill dicotyledonous weeds in turf grass. These herbicides do not harm the grass, which is a monocot, but they could not be used in a landscape planting because the ornamental grasses are dicots and would be injured or killed. An example of a monocot we eat is corn. The seedling looks like the illustration, a furled straight tube. An example of a dicot we eat is the green bean. You can separate the seed into two halves, and the seedling will have two seed leaves. Knowledge of the life cycle of a particular weed species is important for management. For example, mowing a patch of annual weeds to remove the flowers can prevent seed set. Refrain from cultivating areas where weeds reproduce by rhizomes. Cultivating cuts the rhizomes into pieces, and each piece can generate a new weed plant. Annual weeds complete their life cycle in a single year. If they do not produce seed, they are effectively controlled. However, be aware that if plants have produced seed in the past, that seed bank remains in the soil to sprout in future years. Summer annual weeds grow each spring or summer from seed. Examples include prostrate spurge and ragweed. They mature, produce seed, and die in one growing season. Seeds generally remain dormant during the winter before germinating the following spring. The majority of annual weeds are of this type. Some annuals, such as crabgrass, can root from leaf-stem junctions, forming dense colonies. Winter annual weeds, such as cheatgrass, medusa head, and tumble mustard, germinate from seed in the fall to late winter. They mature and produce seed during the following spring and die in early summer. Seeds of winter annuals remain dormant during the late spring and summer to germinate the following winter. Biennial weeds may germinate at any time during the growing season. Examples include bull thistle and musk thistle. They usually produce a radial cluster or rosette of leaves lying close to the soil during the first season. In the second year, they produce flower stalks using food stored from the first season's growth, produce seeds, and die. They are easiest to control in the first year by removing the rosettes. Perennial weeds live for 3 or more years. Some species may not flower the first year, while others may produce seeds that do not germinate. Many perennials, such as curly dock, dandelion, and common milkweed, spread primarily by producing seeds, while others, such as field bindweed, perennial pepperweed, and purple loosestrife, spread both by seed and vegetatively. The latter occurs when attached or broken pieces of rhizomes, stolons, or stem nodes touch the soil and grow new roots. Perennials are the most difficult weeds to control. Remember that annuals must produce seed to produce new plants. However, if the annuals have reproduced successfully in that location in the past, a substantial seed bank or stored accumulation of seeds will exist. A great example of this is puncture vine or goat head. It is easy to remove by pulling, but deposits its seeds to sprout in future years. So control must combine removal of this year's plants before they can set seed with control of sprouting of existing seeds. Some seeds from perennial plants may stay viable for many years. Spotted knapweed seeds, for example, will sprout as long as 20 years after they have been produced. Because perennials reproduce not only by seed but also by roots, control must remove or kill the root of the plant. Be aware that digging may leave parts of root fragments in the soil, which may then produce new plants. This perennial has creeping underground roots that produce new plants. At least four plants are contained in this small fragment.